just doing a super informal Facebook Live tonight. I know I didn't get a chance to go live last week, and I almost didn't go live tonight, but I decided I at least want to squeeze in the sign-by-sign card pulls for the week, so I am here to do that. And I'm just going to clear any and all negative energy from my auric field and from my space, and just do concentric circles of Saint Germain's violet flame and white light. I also want to create a sacred container of love and light and pure white angelic light to preserve in this space. And, you know, usually the way I do my Facebook Lives is that I go over astro updates as well as business updates. Hi, Brandy. Doing a really informal Facebook Live tonight. Just gonna go straight to the sign-by-sign card pulls for the week. Really almost didn't do a Facebook Live tonight. I'm really tired and haven't had the greatest day. But I decided I still wanted to pop on to get in some sign-by-sign card pulls for the week. What was I saying? So yeah, just some quick notes. So astrologically, you know, it's really interesting because I just saw, like, in my newsfeed recently that this really famous cathedral is actually burning in Paris. And as I was looking at, you know, the photos and everything, it just really brought to mind a lot of astrology aspects, which are long-standing astrology aspects that have gone on last year, absolutely into this year, and into next year. So it was interesting to kind of see that, you know, even though it was, you know, nobody was really hurt. I think one person was injured, but nobody died. But certainly, you know, just like seeing the images is intense. But yeah, it just really brought to mind like how powerful astrology is as a tool for us to understand, you know, what's happening with our energy and what's happening with world energies, and to not neglect the power of astrology. And you know, we have the moon in Virgo tonight. The moon moved into Virgo last night or early today, sometime in that window. And we have, you know, of course, Jupiter is still transiting in Sagittarius. Some of the same things that I talk about week to week, you know, with Jupiter and Saturn are still going on. But when the moon changes sign, that of course changes up the flavor of that energy, right? So
it depends like what house you have that
sign in and how that particular sign is in aspect to the outer planets, right? So, again, not really wanting to get too in-depth in tonight's live tonight, but,
oh, the audio bomb's
going in and out. Okay, let me put in headphones. Good call, sister.
Okay, so I was sort of just rambling a lot about astrology and just some things I've been witnessing recently and many things like that. So I could kind of go back over it a bit, but essentially what I was talking about is just this current world event, which is this really famous cathedral in Paris, the Notre Dame Cathedral, actually caught fire while they were renovating it and is burning. So as I was looking at the video footage of this happening and some of the news articles on it, gratefully, nobody really got hurt. I think one person was injured, but nobody died or anything as far as I saw when I looked. But I really was reminded of some outer planet aspects going on in the astrology, which have been strengthening recently and are very long-standing aspects. So these are aspects that started, you know, about a year ago, and we're really into the thick of it now, and they will be continuing into next year. And these are aspects which involve the planets Pluto and Saturn, which affect more of society and the world as a whole. Now, there's so much that could be said about this, but, you know, Pluto's been in Capricorn for a while, and Saturn's transiting in Capricorn. So these two planets are becoming increasingly closer to each other, and they will conjunct at the beginning in January of 2020. And the energy of this is all about destroying, and I'm putting that in quotes, but hi, Diana! The energy of this is about, you know, destroying structures or traditions that previously exist in the world, and sort of, in a sense, demolishing the old so that new can be rebuilt better and stronger. And a lot of these traditional systems may be in things that have been very long-standing in society, like governmental structures and religious structures. So I just find it really interesting witnessing, this figure that is a church, a representation of the church that's actually, burning, and how that is so very much like that transit of Pluto and Capricorn. Because although Pluto is a dense, dark planet, it doesn't have fire to it like, some of the other planets would. It is 100% associated with. Love you too, Diana. I'm just doing a really informal live tonight. Almost didn't make it because I'm really tired and it's just been a lot lately. But I saw some things going on, that I just felt called to pop on, and I wanted to make sure I did the sign by signs for the week as well. But anyway, so yeah, kind of witnessing this, iconic traditional figure associated with, the church and how it was burning, just for me, it just really spoke to that Pluto and Capricorn transit, which is about the death and the rebirth of traditions and structures in society. And that, that's the way that Pluto works. It's like the Tower card. It comes in and it sort of destroys the old in order for the new to be rebuilt stronger. And there's definitely this component of it as well, which is like with the phoenix, and it's re being reborn from the ashes. So I just thought it was really interesting, and definitely my prayers and my thoughts go out to anybody that's being affected by that. But it appears as though, thankfully, like nobody's been, there's only been like one injury from when I had looked. So I did want to speak about that, and with the moon in Virgo, it's certainly creating a lot of tense aspects to other mutable energy, like the Sagittarius energy right now and the Piscean energy right now. I think that's why I'm feeling it so strongly. I just had a day where like nothing was going right from start to finish, just nonstop, one thing after another, even starting into last night. So I wouldn't be surprised if the moon moved into Virgo last night. And normally, when a moon moves into the sign that is your sun sign or that you have a lot of personal planets in, it doesn't automatically equal a good thing. It depends on what other planets are active in the astrology and how they're aspecting that energy. So in my case, the moon being in that sign is actually inflaming or aggravating aspects that I'm already under with these long-standing transits with some of the Sag energy and some of the slightly shorter term energy, and some shorter, some longer in Pisces. So astrology is like this really intimate dance, where that's why I love it, because it's just layer upon layer and it's like infinite variables and it's very complex, and there's all these moving parts that you're sort of studying and coordinating how they interact with each other. I've had a rant on my Facebook lives before about this, but do make sure that if you're receiving messages, kind of like one note astrology messages where somebody tries to do a blanket statement of this is what the day is going to be like for Aries or Taurus or what have you, which it's ironic because I'm going to do something slightly similar to that in a minute with cards. But I feel like it's just important to remember that you are made up of many components. So although your sun sign may be one sign, you have a moon sign and a you have a moon sign, you have a rising sign, you have a house system, you have planetary placements, right? So there's a diversity to your energy. And ultimately, if you read something or you witness something and the information from that doesn't resonate as true, then you have to respect that too. You have to respect that that's your intuition or your inner being saying, look, I don't vibe with that right now. And maybe I resonate with like 1% of that, but not the other percentage of it, and that's okay too. So I think sometimes understanding how to step back and just be in alignment with what your authentic voice is saying and what your personal power is saying is so very important. I went through something last week which really challenged my personal authority and really caused a lot of stress within me. And in general, Aries season has been a lot of reconnecting with my personal power. Aries energy is very important for me in my chart. Although I'm a Virgo with a moon in Libra, Aries is an important energy because it contains my North Node at the beginning of Aries, and then at the end of Aries, it contains my Jupiter. So, And it's the sixth house, which is the house of service, and Virgo, which is my sun sign. So there's a lot that's included in Aries. And, you know, I've just been witnessing that pulling back and getting more in alignment with what my authentic voice says is so very important, because ultimately people have all different kinds of opinions and you can get lost in those opinions. But sometimes you have to really understand when is appropriate to unplug from that and create some space from the situation in order to kind of get more clear about who you are and what you really want. You know, just because somebody wants something from you doesn't mean it's necessarily the best fit for you. You may actually have to go in and really kind of connect with what's real for you, you know. And also with Venus transiting through Pisces and Mercury finishing up in Pisces, poor Mercury has been through so much. It's really ready to get out of the sludge that it's been in. You know, with Venus transiting in Pisces and then with Mercury there and then Neptune, they're all like having this confusion party together, you know, where sometimes it's like the relationship decisions you have to make may not always be so clear, you know. And I think it's important to remember that as we move into the energy later into this week, for sure, by the time we get into like the second half of this week, Mercury will move into Aries at last. But then next week, Venus will move into Aries. So we'll start to shift, you know, and then of course we go into Taurus season. So it really changes things up. But just keep in mind that there's still some confusion going on with, you know, two major planets that we work with on the Earth, you know, Mercury and Venus, being in the final sign of the zodiac. And there was another thing I was going to say with that, but I forget what it was. Don't remember, but it'll come to me if it's important. So, and then I also do want to do a shout out if people are interested in joining my Fearlessly Fairy group. It's a good time to start thinking about that for next month. It's $20 a month. It's a great deal. You get access to a weekly emailed message. You get a focus document for the month that I write and includes reflection questions. You also get a 20% discount on any private readings with me. And there's also a private Facebook group. So definitely let me know if you're interested in that. And yeah, it's really bugging me. I can't remember what it was I wanted to say about Venus, Mercury, and something with that. But it's just eluding me right now. Which is very Mercury and Pisces, so it's appropriate. trying to think. Yeah. So anyway, without further ado, I'm going to go into a sign-by-sign card pull for the week. So I'm going to go through all 12 signs of the zodiac. So with this, you want to be mindful of the messages for your sun sign, your moon sign, and your rising sign. So if you have three different signs in that, you might want to be paying attention to three different messages. If you know what your first house is, I also would strongly recommend paying attention to the message for that, because that's actually a very good indicator as well of what's happening for you energetically. For example, with myself, I'm a Libra rising, but I'm a Libra rising at 29 degrees. So that means that I was born at the final most degree of Libra on my ascendant, which is a very potent degree in astrology as well. The 0 degree, the 01 degree, and the 28, 29 degrees are very important degrees. Yes, please do, Diana. I think you'll be a great addition to the group for sure. Those degree windows are very interesting ones in astrology. They have a different kind of energy than degrees that would land in the middle. So because my ascendant's at 29 degrees, I actually pay attention to Scorpio messages, because Scorpio is my first house, and is also very important energy for me. So just as an example. Okay, so let's see. For this week, what does Aries need to know? Aries, Aries, Aries. Funny, I tried to do this in a different way, because again, I just, like I said, I almost didn't make it on. I was trying to do it in a slightly different way and video it from my desk, and I started to lay out the piles, but then I realized I didn't have enough room, and I was just like, you know what, I'm just gonna go and set up my setup and just do it. So maybe that's a message for us all, is kind of like just go with the flow right now. And you know, you'll know logically if it's in front of you, you'll know logically, can I do this or not? You know, like the experience that I went through last week, physically my body did not even want to go to the location that would have involved exploring what that was. And that was a really big sign for me, along with, you know, so many other things. But sometimes there's just a logic, you know, that's there. And sometimes it's hard to access that logic when we're really emotional. But once we move past the emotion, move through the emotion, yes, you definitely should, Diana. It's so valuable to understand astrologically what's cooking, because it's super complex and I love it, and that is my joy, you know, is being like a linguist of the stars. So for sure, I'd love to help you with that. Okay, so let's see. So Aries, Aries, Aries for this week. We've got two cards, it looks like. Aries, Aries. Okay. So for Aries, we have second chakra Archangel Ariel, and then we have reverse the thinking man. So for Aries, I'm actually drawn to the reverse, I'm drawn to the reversed, the reverse the thinking man card, which might mean that the presence of certain male energy in your life is a little depleted right now. This could also mean that you're not fully in connection with your divine masculine, or that kind of like more masculine energizing component of that yang energy, you know, being able to get up and get things done and do. So there's a little bit of a void there with the divine masculine. But we also have Archangel Ariel, second chakra, which is, she is the Archangel of Strength. She's like the feminine equivalent of Archangel Michael. And she's also associated with the sacral chakra, which is all about creativity. So my advice for Aries this week would be to, while there's sort of like this absence or void of maybe that male energy, and there's maybe like a little bit of a depletion of the yang energy, I think it's a really good time to get into creative endeavors. So focus on creatively, what can you do right now? What can you express right now creatively? And you can also call in Archangel Ariel. So that is for Aries. For Taurus, 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 Taurus. What does Taurus need to know for this week? Pretty good card. We got number four, Happy Family. So for Taurus this week, it's focusing on the positive love-filled relationships that you have in your life right now. And good, I'm glad, Brandy. The positive love-filled relationships you have right now in your life, and how that's just making you feel really good. I'm also really drawn to the number four there, so pay attention to seeing repeating messages like 444 or things like that. But overall, a really positive card there for Taurus. And if I think about by solar method, Aries would be the 12th house for Taurus by solar method. So this means that Aries season for Taurus is just by the solar method, not by what's actually in their chart. This is a different type of method we use in astrology. You know, this is kind of like a more spiritual time. It's a more free-flowing time. So for Taurus, part of the message may be too to like not force things, you know, that things will work themselves out, and to kind of just really go with the flow right now and focus on the connections in your life that are feeling really good. All right, Gemini. Gemini, Gemini, Gemini. What does Gemini need to know for this week? We have the thinking woman, but in reverse. So interesting that I'm getting both the thinking man and the thinking woman in these cards. I actually pulled this card for myself earlier, and I can really relate to this. And you know, Virgo and Gemini. Hi, Denise. Virgo and Gem, your name is familiar, but I don't know why. Virgo and Gemini are both ruled by Mercury, you know, so although they're both mutable signs and they technically square each other because they represent different elements, they're both ruled by Mercury. So they have that in common, which is that they would prefer to be of the mind. They really like communication, you know. So for Gemini this week, we have reversed the thinking woman. So I actually feel like that's a nod to say that for Gemini this week, it's like you're very much in your head and your thoughts, and maybe it's time to kind of like chill that a bit, you know. It's not ringing a bell, Denise. I'm sorry. But welcome to my Facebook Lives. I usually do my Facebook Lives on Monday nights, and like this is a really informal one. So a little bit out of the usual tradition of how I kind of style them. But yeah, so anyway, back to the card for Gemini. So it's like, you know, we're very much for Gemini this week. It's like you've been so much in your head, you've been thinking about so very much. I feel like it's time to sort of just chill the thinking woman a bit and to relax a little bit more and to, you know, just rest and maybe meditate if you can. But to try and just seek out ways in which to just, you know, get into more of a flow and an ease. And if you're meeting opposition or blocks or obstacles around the ways in which you're trying to access that, just continue to surrender into it. Yeah, I don't remember Denise. I don't follow her anymore. And that was like so many years ago. So I have just like blocked that out. And I don't participate with them anymore. And I don't have an affiliation with them in any way anymore. Had a very negative experience. So just, yeah, no, I'm not connected to that group anymore. But anyway, I wanted to share a quick story related to what I was talking about with this. So, you know, today, like I said, I kind of started the day off. There's just been a lot today, and I made a decision where I wanted to do something to kind of help me relax a bit more. So I went and sought that out, and it sort of didn't work out as I thought, you know, and that was a little bit of a bummer because I thought, okay, I'm doing great self-care by going in this direction and doing this. And then I kind of met some opposition when I got there because there was confusion about the time and when I signed up for it and things like that. So, but then I came home and like I kind of laid on my bed. I have like an acupressure mat that I use. I strongly recommend these so very much. I have one in like a pillow form, like a rounded form. And then I have one in like a sheet form. And I lay on those on my bed. And it's like a great way to kind of get like a mini acupuncture or even like a mini, it's not a massage experience in the way where it's like stimulating the tissue, but it's certainly creating an effect. So I laid on that and then my dog jumped on my bed and he just was like licking me all over, like all over my legs and my feet. And he's like a super licker. He's always licking my toes. But it just was really funny because what I had wanted to do was actually go and get like a back massage. This massage place by me, you know, they have different prices for like foot reflexology, full body, and then back massage. And the back massage is like this creative way I found to get a massage at like a more affordable rate because they literally only do your back. But there was like a mix up about the time and it's like this whole thing. So it was just really funny because I got back on my bed and my dog was basically giving me like a doggy massage. She was just like totally loving on my like my legs and my feet and just like licking me. And I was just like, you know what? I'm just surrendering into this, that didn't work out, but this is happening now. And I just surrender and I just allow, you know, and I feel like that's definitely the energy and the message of Venus in Pisces and Mercury in Pisces and all of that, you know. Is just a lot about surrender. And it's funny too, because, you know, I love my dog. He is like my child. He's so very important to me. And in the past 24 hours, there's been a lot of stress with my dog because he gets very anxious about the weather and we've had terrible weather here. Last night, terrible storms came through. I know, right, Brandy? Terrible storms came through. And then today, just really windy and very ominous and stuff. So he was extremely anxious and very not himself and a lot to handle, you know. So it's just really funny that of all the people to actually make me feel like, you know, like that, it was him, the person that I was trying to, you know. Yeah, so I thought that was a cute story. But anyway, massive derail from the sign by signs for the week. So where was I at? Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer. What does Cancer need to know for this week? All right, so for Cancer, we have attachment, but in reverse. This is number 5. So I actually take this to be a very positive card for Cancer, meaning that you're in a pretty good place where you're not like overly clinging to things. You're letting go of things, you know. Yeah, you do need more pics of him, Brandy. I haven't sent you videos and pictures of him in a little while. he was really, really bad boy last night, though, and today he was really bad last night. He kept me up and just so much. But we did have really bad storms come through very suddenly. And he gets very, very anxious with the storms. And I even have medication to give him for that because it's so severe. But you know, today it was like a lot of wind, and I was like, no, I'm not giving you medicine because I just want, you know, him to be himself. I know the fur baby is like, having a fur baby is so much like a real baby, you know? It's just like, when he doesn't sleep, I don't sleep, you know? And when he's upset, I'm upset. Like, it's just like, we're like the same person, you know? Hi, Amy. It's so fun to see. I literally said at the beginning, like, I almost didn't make tonight's live. This is just like a super informal live, so it's fun to see some of you that I haven't, you know, I just missed last week, but was debating if I needed another week to miss or what to do, and it was just like, you know what, even though it won't be perfect and it won't be my usual, I'm just gonna hop on and, you know, try to get some messages in. I was really inspired. You'll see, if Amy, if you go back and rewatch from the beginning, I was talking about just what I was witnessing with, the Notre Dame Cathedral burning, and when I looked at the video footage and some of the pictures, it just really brought to mind a lot of the astrological aspects that I know are happening, like longstanding, and yeah, it was just very interesting to see what I understand in the energy as an astrologer manifested in the physical world, but at the same time, of course, my, you know, the heart part of me was experiencing the feelings of it, but then I'm also like witnessing it on a spiritual healer teacher level. So it's very interesting. You're so welcome, Diana. Thank you for being here. I just cherish you so very much. So anyway, for Cancer, we are letting go of attachments that were maybe unhealthy. And I feel like you're just in a place of like a good place where you feel like you don't have to cling to things. You feel like you don't have to have certain things, but that it's kind of, and because you're letting go of that control, it's actually flowing a little better. And this actually might be related to money, because that's card number 5 in the deck, which is associated with money. So let's see. So Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer. Okay, Leo. What does Leo need to know for this week? For Leo, we have number 50, Angel of Strength. So this is also related to the Archangel Ariel card, but in kind of a different way. So you know, for Leos, it's like, stay strong, stay focused on your long-term goals. I can certainly relate to this because my midheaven, which is the top of my chart related to my public image and my career, is in Leo. So this is about staying strong in the face of what needs to, you know, what needs to change in your life, what needs to happen, the leadership that you want to embody, being courageous, you know, is a big message for Leos this week. Another aspect of this card too, which sometimes, you know, cards within this that get overlooked, is that it's kind of like the energy of the lion and the lamb, knowing when do you have to kind of roar and when do you kind of have to be the lamb. And both are strong in their own ways, right? But there's a time and a place for each of them, and understanding how to navigate that kind of dichotomy and when to be which is, you know, really powerful. And it's also very much connected to the throat chakra as well, where sometimes we speak up when we don't have to, and it depletes our personal power, right? Or we maybe could speak up more in order to assert our personal power. Again, I was talking earlier in the live about this experience I went through last week, and it definitely included all of those things I just talked about. You know, without getting into too much detail, the person really misusing their power and me being able to see that for what it was. And but being in that and kind of being like the lamb in the conversation, because as an empath, oftentimes what we do is we sort of marry ourselves to the energy of the scene in order to create peace and sort of like placate, right? But then when you step away, you'll realize what your authentic feelings actually are, and you'll kind of come to more terms with that, you know? So that's what happened to me. And then it triggered, you know, a lot of awareness around what I do want and what I do stand for in various things. And this was all related within career. So yeah, it was a lot. but I'm on the other side of that now. So I'm very grateful that I'm on the other side. All right, Virgo. What does Virgo need to know for this week? Virgo, Virgo, Virgo. Oh, I like this card. My Virgo self is like, yes, please. Number 45, man holding a heart. So this is saying the presence of loving energy coming in could be from a particular man. So this could be like romance related. This could also be you realigning with your divine masculine energy and loving on that part of yourself, loving on that yang part of yourself, that strong part of yourself that is that courageous part that can get up and keep going. Very good card. So that's what we have for Virgo, for Libra for this week. Libra, Libra, Libra. Very good. My Libra moon and my Libra ascendant are happy about this. So we have number one, the sun. So this in the upright position is associated with an uptake of energy, being re-energized. This can be related to new beginnings and abundance. What's interesting too is that, a bit later on in this week, we have a full moon in Libra. Interestingly, this full moon in Libra is actually going to be at 29 degrees of Libra, which is exact on my ascendant. And of course, conjuncting my moon because my moon is close within orb of that in my natal chart. So I'm really interested to see. I'm probably already feeling the effects of it. I know I actually felt called to do a lot of emotional releasing work last night, and I do strongly feel that was related to this upcoming full moon. But yeah, it's always interesting, again, being an astrologer and of course knowing my own chart. I don't just do astrology for other people, I also do it for myself, right? I started with giving that medicine to myself first, and that medicine helped me to overcome deep, dark nights of the soul, and move through them because of the awareness that astrology provided, and it still provides me on a day-to-day basis. So it's always interesting for me when I'm going through something like that because I'm witnessing it for myself, and sometimes I have to live it for myself and kind of be like, I'll come back to you later. Other times I can live it and teach and heal other people at the same time. It all depends, it's kind of like a balancing act. So anyway, though, for Libra energy, people with sun, moon, rising, paying attention to an uptake of energy, new beginnings. And because these are the cards for the week, I would also recommend that you think about this as the overall message for the week, but it's something that you accumulate towards as we get towards the end of the week, that's what I find with the weekly card messages I do in my Fearlessly Fairy group. A lot of times, what I do is, that's my paid group, and it's a wonderful group. We have a couple of people in this chat who are in it, and some people are interested. And, I actually re-listen to that message. So before I listen to the new week's message, I re-listen to the previous week because I want to see how I integrated what that message was or how it's resonating, and I can reflect. So it's sort of like I reflect on the old before I accept in the new, if that makes sense. All right, Libra. So we're up to Scorpio. Scorpio, Scorpio, Scorpio. What does Scorpio need to know for this week? Scorpio, Scorpio, Scorpio. All right, so in for Scorpio, we have reversed Angel of Balance, right? This is number 48. So this means that things are a little out of balance. It's like you're thrown off kilter. You feel like things are not quite settling, right? So you have to do some work this week about rebalancing. And very interesting that, with the full moon in Libra, another component of Libra besides relationships and beauty and aesthetics is also balance and understanding balance and making decisions from a balanced perspective. And again, this is what I was talking about a bit earlier in the live. If you know what your first house is, this is where it gets really powerful because I keep using myself as an example, but it's totally my Leo midheaven does this. And I think it's just part of my work is that I lead by example, right? So my life feels very out of balance right now, and I'm working on rebalancing certain things. So much so that I honestly almost didn't come tonight because I felt like, do I need another week off from my Facebook lives to kind of rebalance myself? But here I am. So I will figure out the repercussions of that and figure out how to rebalance, but what I was talking about, where if you read your first house plus your sun, moon, rising, so for me, there would be three cards here, right? So it's basically saying that there's some love coming in, some romance coming in, some connection within the divine masculine, new beginnings, new revitalizing energy, and this is helping me to rebalance my life. So that's how I would read these cards as a personal reading for myself based on my sun, moon, rising, and my first house. For example, oops, my battery's gonna die soon. Let me fix that. For example, I'm gonna put Brandy on the spot because because I know she probably won't mind. But Brandy's a double Aries, right? So for Brandy, the messages that I pulled at the beginning would be really like double important for her, you know, because that was the message for Aries. And then, you know, Brandy's ascendant, the card for that, and then her first house. So that creates like a whole range of cards, right? So this is how you can also use, when people do readings like this, you can use them to your advantage because you know yourself. That's a really good rhythm if you can get both of those in flow. Okay, so where was I at? Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio, Sag. What does Sagittarius need to know for this week? Sag. All right, for Sagittarius, we have reversed the garden and the gate. So this is a card about, you know, there's something that you feel like is elusive to you, or there's something that you want to be made available, but now it feels like it's blocked or like the gate is closed. But actually, that's usually the upright meaning of this card. So because it's in reverse, it's like a double negative. So it may actually mean that it's the reverse of the garden and the gate, which is that the ways in which you maybe were blocking yourself or thought you were blocked to expand into that new horizon are now starting to free themselves up. And what I'm getting a strong message about with that is that Jupiter went retrograde last week, I believe it was. So maybe that because Jupiter's gone retrograde for Sagittarius and Jupiter's transiting in Sag, you know, this is allowing Sages to kind of go back over the opportunities that came in front of them. And this is true for all of us too, by the way. But we're able to kind of revisit those opportunities and really look at them and say, oh yeah, like maybe this is better than I thought. Maybe this has more potential than I thought. Or maybe I did have this, but I was looking over here for the answer, but maybe this still has a lot of potential to get me to over here, you know? So I feel like there's a lot of reflecting on what we have and understanding how what we have could get us to more of what we want instead of feeling like we're blocked to getting to bigger, broader things. Maybe we have to kind of work with what's right in front of us, you know? And I can relate to that as well. All right, so for Capricorn, what does Capricorn need to know for this week? So many reverse cards. You know, I didn't go through and reset the deck, but I'm doing just quick peeks, and you know, a lot of these cards are upright, so it's interesting. So for Capricorn this week, we have journey, but we have it in reverse. So this means that right now it's not necessarily about traveling and excursions and getting out there, Capricorns. It may be about kind of focusing on your inner world, maybe your home life, or just more internal things like your internal dialogue or meditating with yourself more, things like that. But instead of kind of getting out there and projecting your energy out, there's a need to kind of bring that energy back in. And I know that for a while doing my lives, I was pulling a lot of really great cards for Caps about new opportunities and about movement and about just continuing to go for it. So I feel like right now, Caps might be going through a little bit of a dialing back, which is okay. You know, we need that. All right, and then Aquarius. What does Aquarius need to know for this week? Aquarius. So for Aquarius, we have man holding a coin upright. So this is about some type of man or masculine energy in your life presenting something of value. Doesn't necessarily have to be money, but it's something of value to you. Now, this could also be, again, your divine masculine, getting in touch with that masculine part of yourself and it providing value to you. Maybe you're finally starting to work on a project of which you know maybe could lead to some monetary or financial gain. That could also be an interpretation of that card. And then lastly, Pisces. What does Pisces need to know for this week? Pisces. So for Pisces, we have woman holding a coin, number 42. It's interesting that we got both of those. And also interesting that we got reverse thinking woman and reverse thinking man in these card pulls as well. But anyway, so we have woman holding a coin in the upright position. So this doesn't surprise me too much because with Venus transiting in Pisces, Venus is also associated with money. So for Pisces, having Venus move through with your sun, your sun sign, definitely can bring opportunities related to money or success or abundance in some type of form. Pay attention though to women in your life that are offering things like gifts or things that are of value. because that could be coming through really strongly this week. And then let's just do an overall card message for the week. Overall card message for the week. What do we as the collective need to know for this week? Oh, not necessarily a happy card for overall. Let's pull more than that card. I don't want to leave on a sour note. All right, let's confirm for the week, for the week, for the week, for the collective. All right, so the first card that I pulled was upright number 9, broken heart. 9 being a very karmic energy, right? Now, I felt called that I wanted to pull more cards, but what's also coming through with that is the fact that Libra is the planet is ruled by Venus, right? I understand Libra energy so well because my south node's in Libra, my moon's in Libra, my ascendant's in Libra. I have achieved a lot of mastery in Libra energy, but this lifetime I came back to kind of like finish it off, you know? But along with that comes an awareness that not everybody is meant to partner with you. Not everybody is meant to couple with you. Not everybody is a match to, you know, be with you, whether that be in career or friendship or love, all the different ways that we have partnerships, right? Like I was talking about last week, I went through this strongly with this particular individual as related to career. So it's almost like I went through some of that Libra energy in advance, right? And it makes sense because I feel like there's more to come yet with the full moon on my ascendant, but certainly I went through something last week. But anyway, I feel like a lot of us might be breaking some karmic contracts because we have the contract card here. So I feel like a lot of us might be breaking some karmic contracts this week to maybe people or places, partnerships that we previously had, which just don't serve us. There might need to be a breakaway. We might need to like create space from those people or just create change around those partnerships. Or it might just be that somebody tries to enter your life and there's just like a flat out rejection or there's some type of blockage. But I feel like that's important because I feel like you guys might have karmic contracts with those people and that needs to happen. And the other card I pulled was number 41, seventh chakra archangel Uriel. So it's like, if you're feeling really confused about this and unsure about what to do related to these partnerships or these connections, right? These karmic connections, you need to kind of go within and you need to meditate. You really do. That's what helped me a lot last week when I was going through this, was I basically told the person, I need some space around this and I'm going to take a couple days. And then I let myself go through the different cycles of emotion, you know, and there was a range of emotion, you know, within the first 24 hours, there was anxiety. And then after anxiety, I moved into anger. And then beyond anger, it took me a while, but I moved into other things like grief even and despair, and then finally just releasing and letting go of a lot of those feelings. So there will be cycles that you might feel, you know, emotional cycles you might feel. And it makes sense too, because Venus transiting at the end of Pisces, Mercury transiting at the end of Pisces, this is our mind and our heart all up in the feels, all the feelings, all the karmic energy. Pisces is the 12th house of the zodiac. So it's an accumulation of all the energy that comes before it. And that 12th house carries very karmic energy. And Pisces is just very sensitive in that way. It feels everything, you know, because it's kind of carrying the load of everything before it. So there might be a lot of feelings coming up, you know, but because it's the final degrees of that sign, that's also about surrender and letting go and just releasing it to the divine. So it's, I feel like this is actually a pretty strong message for the full moon in Libra for us all, about understanding how to utilize this energy, what may come up and how to channel it, but that ultimately you connecting with you and your higher guides and your source is what's really going to bring you into alignment and bring you centered and more balanced, you know, with everything. So pretty epic for you guys. Thanks for those that hung on for the whole time. I think it's Diana and Brandy if you're still on. I can't see who's on. I can only see it's two people. Yeah, and then, so Diana, definitely let me know, message me about the Fearlessly Fairy group. I'd like to do more impromptu little lives or things in the Fearlessly Fairy group because it's a beautiful container for us, you know, and the people in that group are just so great, and I just love that group so much. And also, if you're in my Fearlessly Fairy group, it is like a guaranteed way that you're going to get my weekly messages for the week. So my Facebook Lives, generally I do once a week, but as I'm navigating the pieces in my life and how to balance them and kind of move things around, sometimes there may be a week where I can't do it or it's on a different day. So my Facebook Lives are sort of like, how do I put this? Like a privilege, but not always guaranteed, you know? Whereas my Fearlessly Fairy group, which is a paid group, it's guaranteed that you're gonna, like, I make sure I schedule that and I make sure that people are getting those weekly messages and that document and all those good things. So it's definitely more guaranteed, you know. And then I was on a great roll doing daily videos for my YouTube, and I'd like to get back into more videos again with my YouTube. I really enjoy doing the pick of cards, and I think you guys like those a lot. And I want to do more of those. But I have a major priority with my spiritual business, which is my website. I have to get my website up and running. So, you know, when you're a spiritual entrepreneur and like you're doing it all by yourself, it's like everything falls on you. And then when you're juggling a spiritual business with also, you know, other things in life, it's just like, it's like a constant juggling act, but I love it. My business is not going anywhere ever. You know, this is absolutely a part of who I am. So like, if you guys don't see me for a week or like you don't see me on social as much, it doesn't mean like my business has stopped. It just means that I may be recalibrating. I may be going through something. I may be rebalancing or something like that. So, and it's all good. Yes. All right. So let's close this container. I want to thank all of the guides, guardian angels, ascended masters, ancestor spirits that were present and able to assist in this space. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I just want to send everyone love that watched this live or catches this on replay. Much love and have a good night. Bye-bye.